I don't think there's any problem noting the severity of this crack. And you know, that guy had labored on with this for a long time, just thinking something was loose down in there. When we took it out, look at the mess that was on those roots. I don't know how he stood it. And the void in the bone was horrendous. So sometimes you can tell that the crack has broken the tooth in half and must be extracted. On the other hand, let's look at a list of things to do that will save you one full appointment and a significant amount of money and time. First, educate the patient about tooth cracks. And that's not too hard. One of our patient education videos goes right through that step by step in about 9 minutes. You look at it, you accept it as being acceptable for you, and then you show it to patients with cracked teeth. You'll do that, I'll bet, once or twice a week. Use a tooth sleuth, which everybody has, or any other instrument to detect the defective cusp. Now, let's say it's a mesial buccal cusp on an upper first molar, but the rest of the cusps feel all right. Prepare the tooth. But we don't know where the crack is yet. That's what I said, prepare the tooth. Make an impression. Place a provisional. And an obtundant cement. Okay, there's a provisional on that tooth. Now, the dental assistant calls the patient about 2 days later. And what's the dental assistant going to ask the patient? Patient, can you see the temporary restoration we put on that tooth? Yeah, I can see it. Instruct them how to place a wood pencil on the occlusal surface of that provisional. And have them bite down hard on the wood pencil and move their jaw right, left, right, left, right, left. Dental assistant will ask, do you feel that? Does it still hurt? And they're likely to say, it doesn't hurt. Now, don't do this too fast. I would suggest that you wait at least a day or two after the prep, because any prep irritates the tooth and macerates the gum unless you're extremely careful. So I would suggest wait a day or two. Let the trauma of that preparation be over. If there is no pain, tell the lab to make the crown. You've already made the preparation and sent the thing to the lab, so have them make the crown. Let's say, however, that there's still pain. What does that say? That says that probably that crack goes to the pulp in some way, shape, or form. Hard to say, hard to determine where it goes. Impossible is the word. And now I have a choice. And the choice is changing because of implants. The prognosis is only poor, but I can tell the patient, if we desire to do so, and you don't mind a little gamble, we can do a root canal in that tooth and send you away for a few weeks and see how it responds. If it responds well, then we can go ahead and do a crown on it. If it's still hurting, we know that the crack has been much deeper than we anticipated, and we better remove the tooth. Many patients don't want to go to that 0.7. Why not? Because there's a root canal fee there, and there's a little patient ill will if it doesn't work. You know that. Therefore, I strongly suggest that you look seriously at the patient themselves, their financial situation, see if they want to gamble. If it were me, I'd want to gamble. I'd want to try to save that tooth. But many patients will say, take it out, get rid of it. Bring the patient back in then for a discussion of the need for endo and a crown, or extraction, an implant, and a crown. That's a major decision, isn't it? At that particular point, you have to decide, am I going to gamble or am I going to take the tooth out, do the implant and the crown? Many people will like to gamble, but many would far prefer to take the tooth out. What have I really said? Determining the type of crack is a difficult situation. I've said, prep the prep and get ready to send it to the lab if the patient tells you there's no pain after they've worn the temporary for a while. What's the next step? If there's still pain, you would give the patient the opportunity to either have endo and try it, or to take the tooth out. And as I said before, many will accept taking the tooth out, but some would say, yes, I'd like to do the root canal, even if we know it's going to fail. Therefore, I've just saved you one full appointment, which many still suggest, and that is put an orthodontic band or something around the tooth and let them go for a while, and then determine if you're going to do a root canal or take the tooth out or what. Try this simple thing. You'll like it. Thanks for being with us. Join us next week. Don't forget.